Good morning, everyone. In the previous video, we have seen class 12, microbes in human welfare. In this, we have seen how microbes are used in household and sewage treatment plants. In this video, we are going to see microbes in production of biogas. Now, let us understand what is the meaning of biogas. Biogas is a mixture that major content is methane gas. It is produced by anaerobic microbial activity during the digestion of biomass with the help of certain bacteria. Biogas is used as a fuel. The type of gas produced by microbes during their growth and metabolism depend upon the microbes and the organic substrate they utilize. Certain bacteria which grow anaerobically on cellulosic material produce large amount of methane along with carbon dioxide and hydrogen. These bacteria are called methanogens. And one such common bacterium is Methanobacterium. Methanogen produce large amount of biogas, that is methane 50 to 70%, carbon dioxide 30 to 40%, and remaining part is hydrogen. Methanogen are also present in anaerobic sludge during the sewage treatment. They are also present in rumen of cattle, where they help in breakdown of cellulosic material in the food and thus plays an important role in nutrition of cattle. Let us see how does the biogas plant work. So this is the biogas plant. The excreta of cattle, commonly called as gobar, is rich in methanogenic bacteria. Thus, the cow dung can be used for generation of biogas called as gobar gas. Cattle dung is available in large quantity in rural area. Hence, biogas plants are mostly functional in rural areas. Biogas plant consists of concrete tank, you can see in the diagram, in which the bio waste are collected and slurry of dung is fed. A floating cover is placed over the slurry, which keeps on raising as the gas is produced in the tank due to microbial activity. Methanobacterium in the dung act as a bio waste to produce biogas. An outlet is also present which connects a pipe that supplies biogas to the nearby houses. There is another outlet from which the spent slurry is removed, which can be used as a fertilizer. This biogas is used in cooking, lighting. Biogas production technology was developed in India mainly by Khadi and Village Industry Commission, KVIC, and Industrial Agricultural Institute, IARI. Now let us see the next topic. Microbes, biocontrol agents. In modern agriculture system, the farmer has to increase use of chemicals such as pesticide, weedicide to control the plant disease and pest. These chemicals, however, are harmful and toxic for the human being, animals, and are polluting the environment, fruits, vegetables. Thus, it is better to use biological agent to save our crop plant from pest. Biocontrol refers to the use of biological methods for controlling plant disease and pest. Biological control of pest and disease. It is the method of controlling pest in agriculture that relies on natural predation and not on chemical organic. Such as organic farming believes that biodiversity furthers health. The more diversity a landscape has, the more sustainable it is. Therefore, the work to create a system where the insects are not eradicated but kept at a manageable level by a complex system of checks and balance within living and vibrant ecosystem. Unlike conventional farming practice where chemical methods are used to kill both useful and harmful life form indiscriminately, this is a holistic approach as it seeks to develop an understanding of the web of interaction between the myriads of organisms, including both flora and fauna in the field. Biological farming approach requires familiarities with various life forms, their habitat, predators, as well as pests, the life cycle patterns of feeding, etc., to use them in biocontrol measures and reduce their dependence on the chemical and pesticides. Some example of biocontrol agents are Laybirds and dragonfly are used to get rid of aphids and mosquitoes. To control butterfly caterpillars, bacteria such as Bacillus thuringiensis are used in form of spray or as dry spores. These are mixed with botten spread onto the vulnerable plants like brassica and fruit trees, where these are eaten by the insect larva. This kills the larva due to the release of toxin in their gut, thereby eradicating the caterpillars, but leaving other insects unharmed. Bacillus thuringiensis toxin genes are introduced into the plant by using genetic engineering method. Such plants are resistant to attack by pests. Vt cotton is one such example. Trichoderma species are free living fungi that are very common in root system ecosystem. They are effective biocontrol agents of several plant pathogens. Baculovirus belonging to genus Nucleopolyhydrovirus are used as a biological control agent. They are excellent for specific, species-specific, narrow-spectrum insecticidal application. They do not have any negative impact on plants, mammals, birds or fish, or even on targeted insects, thus making them useful in overall integrated pest management program. When beneficial insect has to conserve or an ecological sensitive area is being treated. Microbes and biofertilizers. The chemical fertilizers are being used in increasing amount in order to increase the agriculture output. However, due to excessive use of these chemical fertilizers, there is an increase in the pollution of water bodies. Thus, there is a pressure to shift to organic farming. Biofertilizers are the organisms that enrich the nutrient quality of soil by enhancing the availability of nutrient to the crops. The main source of biofertilizers are bacteria, fungi, and cyanobacteria. For example, bacteria, nitrogen fixing bacteria, fix nitrogen into organic form, which is used by the plant as nutrition. Rhizobium is an example. Azotobacter is also one of the examples. Then fungi, if you say mycorrhizae, is an association of fungi and plant, root of the plant. Cyanobacteria, these are autotrophic microbes found in aquatic and terrestrial environment. Most of them fix atmospheric nitrogen, such as anabian and ostoc oscillatoria. So these are all work as a biofertilizer. So here we have completed this chapter. In the next video, we can start with the second.